Hello. Thanks for the invitation. My name is Sename Kofi Agbodinu. I'm architect and anthropologist. And in 2010, I create a platform called L'Africaine d'Architecture to try to put together these two sciences, anthropology and architecture, and develop what we call a neo-vernacular approach and try to study African traditional architecture for build new architecture. And since 2012, L'Africaine d'Architecture is interested to the new technologies, and we develop a program called Low High Tech, who give birth to the first African 3D printer. And I'm supposed to talk about this machine, but I would like to tell you more about all this project, Low High Tech, and all the philosophy behind this project. So I will talk about three projects with three different scales: an urban scale with the project UpCity, a space scale with WellLab, and a product scale with the Wafat. And the three projects are connected because the smart city project UpCity give birth to WellLab, who give birth to the to Wafat. And this presentation is for a 1 hour talk, so I will try to tell my story in 20 minutes, beginning with the UpCity project. But before telling you this story, I would like to present you to two people. The first one is Pierre. Pierre is Masson Tamberma. Tamberma people are very traditional population you find in North Togo and Benin. They are very ritualized. All they do are ritualized. And Tamberma people develop a very nice architecture who is in the world heritage. And Pierre is Otamari. That means that he's the high level for a Masson Tamberma. The second person I would like to introduce to you is Morin. Morin is hacker, and he work in a hacker space in Paris called the Black Box. And Morin spent all this time to build a circuit board to make cloth, who make music or light. And if you think that these two people belongs to two different universe or two opposite universe, you think exactly like me 2 years ago. Me, because I work a lot with Pierre, and I would like to show you some project I do with Pierre. By example, you have this school built in Hertz for 200 young girls and boys, and it's a project we do in low technology and with what we have in our hands. So I say that I thought that these two universes are opposite, and one day I discover the what we call the maker movement and all this movement of Fab Lab. And in this specific space, I saw that they talk a lot about collaboration, sharing, open source, economy, etc. And all these value, I knew them in the traditional African society I used to work with. So since this moment, I beginning to try to see how I can make collaborate these two universe, and we develop the low high tech concept. And I can say that me too, I make the niche experience, and now I am a little bit more appeased in front of new technology because I saw that there is something traditional in this movement. So we begin to work on a urban project we call UpCity, and the UpCity project idea is to help people in a city to have the capacity to build themselves the city instead of wait for politicians or planner. And this by studied traditional society, because in our village in Africa, we don't have architects, urbanists, but we develop architecture who are very nice. Because we have the capacity in village to mobilize, and we have the power to do things. And this capacity and this power, we don't have it in our cities, our modern cities. But with Barcamp and Fab Lab, we think that we can reconquer this capacity. So UpCity project is put together the camp for try to make a collaborative way of working, collective intelligence, and create small lab for people to build themselves the project they imagine during the camp. So we begin to work on this project in the city of Lomé. We choose three sites in the city, and we beginning to develop open source architecture with low high-tech material for these three sites. They are the project we developed during the ArchiCamp, and we try to see how make those projects sustainable. And after this, we try to connect these projects by specialize them in this way. And after have the three projects, the idea is to create a heart of this system, who will be the first fab lab we will create in the city, and who the first community of maker will be initiated, and the first machines will be built and can go to all the area we work on. A little small album of what we do in ArchiCamp. So we have the ArchiCamp in July and August, and we work on, as you can see, a very low tech technology, but also high technology with here the 3D printer. So we go to see Tambema people, try to work with Tambema people. We work on RepRap, by example. We try to see how we can use what we have in our hands in architecture. And in this movement, one of our member beginning to work on his own idea of 3D printer. And all these projects is done with a jury who can find the two person I present you at the beginning of my talk. So now we have made three ArchiCamp in 2012, 2013, and this year in 2004. And how can we do this? We do this by use three type of technology. We make blog camp for try to find bloggers who choose the site we work on. And after this, we make the ArchiCamp when architect, designer, anthropologists come from all over the world and meet the population, try to develop projects with these populations. And after the camp, we create a lab where people can go and try to fabricate themselves the project we developed during the camp. So in 2012, we create WellLab after the ArchiCamp 2012. And in last year, we create WellLab Prime. And this year, we are work on the third lab for this project. So now I would like to tell you more about WellLab. WellLab is the first fab lab we create in Togo, in Lomé. And WellLab is a philosophy, all philosophy of do-it-yourself, collaboration, etc. You have heard a lot of this since yesterday. But the specificity of WellLab is that we work a lot on community. The lab is led by a community of young girls and boys who have to share all the capacity. WellLab is also a space we created in a neighborhood called in a district called Dijolé. We have some tools in this space, very low tool. And so WellLab is a team. We have about 20 young girls and boys now in our community. The middle age is about 19, and we have about 30% of the girls in the community. This one is for present you two of our members, but I don't think I have the time. We develop technological projects in this space, all in open source philosophy. And so we use a lot of e-waste, because the idea of low high tech is to make with what we have in our hands too. And as we know in Africa, e-waste are almost local materials. We use a lot of e-waste. We create also, we develop also project we find in international. We choose this project who can be also low high tech, and we create communities on these projects. We make this with OpenStreetMap project. We create the first OpenStreetMap community in Togo. We do the same thing with the Jerry project. We create the first Jerry Clan Togo. This one is an album of a Jerry Clan workshop. We do a lot of events who are free, and we have a lot of people who, a lot of young people who come to this event for build robots, machine, etc. And since some months, we have also an incubator program. We have created 5 startups in WellApp. And last year, in October, the government launched a program called Forum des Jeunes Entrepreneurs. They choose the 10 best entrepreneurial projects in the country, and 3 of our startups have been in the 10, and one of them win the first prize and is considered that as the best entrepreneurial project of Togo for last year. So now I will tell you about the WAFAT. So the WAFAT project is what we call a democracy technological project. The idea comes from AFAT here, and we give his name to the machine. And the idea is to use e-waste and dyed machines for build new machines. And so, as I told you, we have a lot of e-waste dump now in Africa. In Ghana, near of us, we have the biggest e-waste dump in the world. It's an entire district covered by e-waste. So we try to think to see how we can manage this problem, and maybe build a new machine we can send back to the West, because it is the West who send us all this this waste. It is a collaborative project. The project is the project of the WellApp community. It's not the project of an only one person. So we, all of the members of our community can talk about this project and can appropriate this project. And it is a project who have a lot of success at in international. And Adrien Bouyer said that this is the future of the of the 3D print of the RepRap project. And but everybody don't have the faith of Adrien Bouyer. And a lot of journalists ask us how we do with this 3D printer. You have created the first African 3D printer, but what you do it for solve problem in Africa. But for the moment, that's what we do with this printer. We have a lot of architects in our community, so we make architectural model, we make some gadgets, but we are not happy of this. We would really like to find application, urgent application. So we launch a series of program we call 3D Print Africa to find best way to use the 3D print technology in Africa. And we have about 5 programs. I will tell you about 3 of these programs. The first program is Africa Cyber Today Print Cafe. The idea comes from President Obama, who says that with only 15 3D print centers, the United States will be at the front of the next industrial revolution. So we choose to put a 3D printer in all our cyber cafe in Africa, so we will be at the front and not the USA. So we're beginning to work on this program in the neighborhood of Wellab. We have identified all the cyber cafe near of us, and the idea is to build a WAFAT and put it in all these cyber cafe and work on the soft, etc., to see how this new service can work in cyber cafe in Africa. The second program is 3D Print Africa Conf. We make a lot of conference. We begin in December last year to tell about this project to the specialists. The first conference we make is with doctors. We put together 50 of the best doctors we have in Togo, and we present them the technology, and we ask them to tell us what we can do with this machine for their specific domain. And the idea is to make a lot of conference like this, and every time with a specialist of a specific domain. After this conference, we begin to work on print prosthesis element the National Prosthesis Center send us. The third program is Africa 3D Print Educative. We have also a pilot of this program. We work with a school near of Wellab, and we have a class of 13 girls and boys, and we teach them how to draw in 3D and print in 3D. And the idea is, this program is successful, is to change the scale and put a 3D printer in many schools in Togo or in Africa. So all this project win the first prize in Barcelona, the first prize of the Global Fab Award in Barcelona, which is a great achievement of what we do in Togo since 2 years. Thank you.
Any question?
Yes, just.
Hello. My question is about the projects are great, and one I see is especially that you are working with the public services in order to make not only an open source project somewhere for experts, or business projects in the new field of open hardware and open models, but especially where you are living, trying to change the life of the people working with the public services of the city, and also, as I see, perhaps with the government. I just want to know, when you are meeting somebody of the local government or the government of the Togo who perhaps has never heard of digital fabrication or open source mechanisms, is it easy to succeed to explain the potential to hybrid what you are doing with people paid by the public services to put machines in the public spaces? And perhaps you've got key points to succeed to convince these people that can be very useful to share with the other, trying to move things in the cities and the countries. So please share it with us.
We have our Minister of Technology is a young woman who is very connected and who supports us a lot with her her congratulation. When she saw a project which can interest us, she talked to us about this project, and we hope that in the future this collaboration will go front and maybe we will have some concrete exchange with the government. For now, we don't have any real program with them. We develop our projects as marginal in French, but if we work a lot in service, it's because people ask us a lot what we can do with the 3D printer, but we don't want to say that we can do this and we can do that. Our objective is to put the 3D printer in every hand, and people will find themselves what they will do. They will do with this machine.
Another question.
I really loved your presentation. How do you cope with the management of all these ideas that converge? Because it's not easy to. You were talking about at least 6 or 5 startups. How do you cope with the management of that?
The management of the startup is something we invent in WELLAB. We have about 20 members in our community, and we have five startups, but all the members are chief of this startup. We are all around the table, and we decide all for the five startup, and we work all of us work in the five startups. But the startup is also in the proximity philosophy of WELLAB. The five startups are prototyped for work one for the other. So even if you don't have a contract outside, we can work, one startup can work for another, and we have a sort of global economy in WELLAB before try to find clients outside the lab. I don't know if it is clear. And we manage it with our own resources from now, and we maybe in the future those startups will gain money and will help us to go front.